गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। स्टिल स्टूडेंट्स आर जॉइनिंग, प्लीज बी रेडी विथ योर डाउट्स। एज आई मेंशन्ड डाउट्स सेशन।
सर आई हैव डाउट्स लाइक आई हैव सेंट यू वन पीडीएफ राइट सर, whether it's correct or not, that's my doubt sir.
How many times I should say Bhargava? I said it is correct, but it is not at all required for you now. Yes, okay, you have done right, great job, but it is not required for you now. It is correct only, I said.
Okay sir,
multiple times I said it is correct. Any other doubts? Evening everyone. Children, you may ask the doubts.
Sir, I'm not able to hear you, sir. You're not audible.
I just asked you to ask the doubts. I just asked you to post your doubts in the WhatsApp. How many of you did this? No one has done that.
Sir, I posted it, sir.
You did not post it yesterday, Emma. You posted long back.
Yes, I'm having that one only doubt.
You don't have anything apart from that?
Sir, even I have posted doubts.
When did you post?
Sir, it was long back. Means like it is not so much long back, but I think it's a week ago.
Okay.
Sir, I'm sorry if you're not mistaken, sir, but the PDF which I sent yesterday is the third quadrant. Not in the first and second one.
Which one?
The PDF which I sent yesterday is the angles in the third quadrant.
No, look at this here. No problem. Whatever the quadrant, like, you know, third quadrant is nothing but 270 minus and 180 plus.
Yes.
Yes. So accordingly, you can solve. You need not to worry much. You know, we are, however, you are going to learn that. I'll explain it clearly. Don't worry. All right.
Okay, sir.
Is that clear?
Excuse me, sir.
One second, Harini. Bhargav, is that clear? Do you have any doubts still?
Sir, I have no other doubts than that.
Okay, fine. Very good. Yes, tell me, Harini.
Sir, can you admit me, sir? I'm dying from other device.
You don't? Okay. Yes. There's a power cut, so I may disconnect at any time. You stay as long as possible. Try to connect with the mobile data. Don't depend on your Wi-Fi. Okay, Garuni. Yes. Everyone look at this here. Harini, what do you want me to explain from this histogram?
I did not ask about histogram, sir.
Not Harini. What is her name? Taruni. What do you want me to explain from this? Basically, histograms, like, it's like a bar graph only. Tell me. Hello? Taruni? This is like histogram. Basically, this is a class interval here. This is a class interval. And this is a frequency. So here we are talking about class interval. This is a this is a frequency and this is a class interval. Okay. So tell me now, what do you want me to explain here? You know, there might be a question that he might be asking such questions like, what is the frequency? What is the frequency of class interval 7 to 10.5? He might ask this kind of question. Then you might, you know, you should answer that. What is the frequency of class interval 10 to 10.5 or 10.5, you say? What is the class interval of 7? What is the frequency of class interval 7 here? So if you talk about that somewhere like, you know, 290, something like that, isn't it? 290, something like that. Look at this, it's somewhat equal to 290, not exactly 300. Okay. So this type of question they might be, you know, asking you. Apart from this, anything else? Harini, you did not ask any doubts, only you just posted an image. What do you want me to explain?
Like, not about that image, sir. I have doubt in coordinate geometry, sir. While I was practicing,
just a minute, Harini. Wait, let us know, complete this and then we'll go for that.
Yes, sure.
Taruni, are you here? Taruni, she is not responding whether you are here or not. So, by looking at this diagram, what are the questions you want me to solve, Harini? Taruni. If you tell the question, so we can solve, Taruni. If not, if you don't have any doubts, we'll go further. So you might get a question like, what is the frequency of the class interval called 7? So what is the class intervals having the greatest frequency? What is the cumulative frequency of the class interval from 10 to 10.5 to 14, something like that? Construct a short frequency table of the distribution. This kind of questions he might be, you know, constructing the cumulative frequency of the table. You might ask, you know, he might be asking you this kind of questions, guys. what do you call it? Taruni has not, you know, asking the questions. She has not posted any questions. She has posted only this frequency, you know, the histogram diagram. So basically by looking at this diagram, what kind of questions he might be asking you. The questions whichever I just now told, the questions whichever I just told now. So that kind of questions he may ask. All right. What kind of questions are there? So what is the frequency of particular class interval? What is the class intervals? Which class interval having a greatest frequency? So what is the cumulative frequency of the class? And so. What is the cumulative frequency of a particular class? So construct a short frequency table of the distribution. Construct a cumulative frequency table of the distribution. This kind of questions you might ask. Yes, apart from this, you don't have anything. And you just have to fill, you know, find accordingly. Cumulative frequency, I told you how to, you know, calculate cumulative frequency. Yes or no? Cumulative frequency, how we calculate cumulative frequency? Look at this here. First, suppose I have here class interval. Class interval, let us say some 10 to, what is this? Class interval, let us say 0, here 0 to 0, here 3 to 5, 7 to 0, and what is this? 14.5, something like that. Here 0.0, 3.5, 7.0, 10.5, and so on. He has given. Okay. Yes. Now frequency. Frequency. If I talk about frequency, look at it here. Yes, any doubts? Yes, Taruni. Taruni, do you understand this or not? Tell me. Yes. Now look at this. I'm just giving you, let us say the class interval is, this is a class interval here. 10.5. Can you hear my voice? 14.0, 17.5. Can you hear me all?
Yes, sir.
Yes, 24.5. Now, if I talk about what is the frequency of this one? 0. 3.5. What is the frequency of 3.5? You take something like 200. Okay.
Sir, Taruni is not connected to audio, so she will not listen to me.
No problem. You listen the class. Okay. Deco, next 7. Yes, 250, something like that, 250. 10.5, again, you have somewhere 180. And so on. Let us say like that. Now, if I ask you to find cumulative frequency, how do you find cumulative frequency? Which I must look at 0. 0 plus 200, which gives me 200. Again, 200 plus 250. Which gives me 450. Again, 450 plus 180. 450 plus 180, 630, something like that. And so on. You must calculate like this. This is a cumulative frequency. So this kind of question also he might ask you. Clear? Yes. So if she doesn't listen, she will be listening in recording session. No problem. Yes. Any other doubts? What about other? What about others? Yes. Harini, tell me, what's your doubt?
Sir, in coordinate geometry, like the sentences, 1 second, sir, I'm opening. Sir, like the perpendicular distance of a point from y-axis is called its abscissa. So, can you explain this sentence, sir? This.
Just a one second, one second.
Yes.
Yes, tell me, Harini. Can you please repeat it again? Yes, yes. Tell me.
Yes, sir. The perpendicular distance of a point from y-axis is called its abscissa, sir.
You can say perpendicular. So can you... 1 second. Perpendicular distance.
Perpendicular distance of a point from y-axis is called its abscissa, sir.
Look at this here. From I'm taking a point on y axis. If I draw a line, this is perpendicular to y only, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Perpendicular distance. From, if I take any point on y axis, x coordinate will be zero, yes or no? Let us say
yes,
this is from A units. From here to here is A units. So 0, comma A. So here, abscissa is what here?
0, sir.
Abscissa. And A is what here? Ordinate.
Ordinate.
This is what I'm trying to explain, isn't it? So x axis and y axis. So perpendicular distance from a y axis. So if I take any point on a y axis, if I just draw, look at the perpendicular line. Yes, sir, it's a perpendicular to y-axis, yes or no? This is what your question. Can you please repeat one more time?
Yes, sir. The perpendicular distance of a point from y-axis is called its abscissa, sir. The perpendicular distance of a point from y-axis is called its abscissa.
This is what, look at this here. 1 second, guys. Can you see here what I'm writing here? Guys, can you see what I'm writing here?
No, sir.
1 minute, 1 minute. Now?
Yes, sir.
Look at this here. If you take a point on a y-axis, if you draw a perpendicular. Now, or else, look at this. The x-coordinate of a point. X-coordinate is what here? Abscissa, right? Y-coordinate, sir, is what? Ordinate.
Yes, sir. We can see.
Here, I'm saying. X-coordinate is called abscissa. Huh? Yes, or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, so, sir.
Look at this here. The, wait a minute. The x coordinate, let me write here, the x coordinate of a point is its perpendicular
to x
distance from where? From the y axis. Why? Because on y axis x point will be always zero. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Exactly. Y-axis. From the y-axis measured. How you measure? Measured along the x-axis.
Sir, so perpendicular distance comes.
1 second. So y-axis. Measured along the x-axis. This also can be called as, or you say that x-axis, which is also called as, which is also very good doubt, which is also called as abscissa. One second. I think he has some doubt. Piyush, I think he is not able to join. Just a minute. Let me admit him. Piyush, are you here? Piyush, are you here?
Yes, sir. Hello.
Yes.
Sir, are you able to hear me?
Yes, yes, yes. What is the problem? Look at this here. The x-coordinate of, Harini, you understand here? The x-coordinate of a point is perpendicular. X-coordinate of a point is perpendicular distance from the y-axis. If I ask you that, y-coordinate of a point is perpendicular from the x-axis. Look at this here. If I talk about y-coordinate, if I take a point, if I draw a perpendicular, that will be perpendicular to x-axis. Yes, yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes.
And point of intersection of all these called as coordinate x, comma y. Sir,
okay.
Yes, sir. If I draw a line on y-axis, that will be perpendicular to x-axis, which means x-coordinate will be zero. So look at the note here. The x-coordinate of a point is perpendicular distance from the y-axis measured along with the x-axis. So this will be measuring along with the x-axis. Then x-axis will measure just now. So the x-axis, if I just measure it along with the x-axis, x-coordinate on y-axis will be of course zero. So that is what called as abscissa. If I talk about abscissa, what is abscissa here? Abscissa is zero. Why? Because on y coordinate, anywhere, on y coordinate you take anywhere, a point will be always zero. All right. Yes.
Yes, sir.
This is how we can just.
Yes, sir. And even I have one more doubt, sir. The x coordinate of a point on the y axis is zero, sir. Can you explain this also?
Sorry, x coordinate. Can you please repeat again? X coordinate
of the point on the y-axis is zero, sir.
One second. X coordinate
of the point
on the
y-axis is zero, sir.
Very good doubt. On the y-axis is zero. Because x coordinate, I'll be having, if I just write a point, x and y coordinate will be zero. So, right, x coordinate of a point on y axis is zero. Here is zero, and y coordinate is something. Yeah, let's say that. Look at it here. X coordinate of a point on the y axis is zero. Very, very simple. Many times we have discussed. Just know I told, right, this is my x axis, beta, this is y axis. Ikkada zero kada, idi origin kada. Ana kada.
Yes.
This is my origin, 0, 0, which is called as origin. Right, look at, let us say I'm asking you to plot 2, 3. If I ask you to plot 2, 3, how do you plot 2 on x-axis? I mean, x-axis lo rendu, and it will be measuring 2. Yes or no?
Yes,
on x-axis will be measuring 2. So here 2, on y-axis will be taking 3. So 2, 3 will be somewhere here. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And first we are looking at x coordinate and then we are looking at y coordinate. Okay, fine. Huh. This is what you understood, right? Plotting the point, you know, right? Now come to your question. Let us come to your question. Your question is x coordinate of a point on y axis. If you put y axis, look at this here. Here 1, gada. Here 0, gada.
Yes, sir. It's zero.
Yes. This zero, look at this. This, look at this axis. Yes, an entire y axis. A point on this one y axis. Look at this. On y axis, if I talk about, what is this? In endi. Then one, can I write 0, 1? 0, 2?
Yes.
0, 3? And x axis, no. On y axis, A point on this. Whatever the point you take, it will be always zero only. X coordinate, నేను మాట్లాడేది x coordinate గురించి, ఇది x coordinate, ఇది y coordinate. Okay na? X coordinate on y axis will be always zero. Now if I ask you the same, what is the y coordinate on x axis?
Zero, sir.
Zero, of course. On y axis, only y coordinates will be available. X coordinate will be always zero. On x axis, only x coordinates will be available. Y coordinate will be always zero. Okay, you just imagine the situation. Here I have zero here. Look at this here. Zero. If I just go along with the y-axis, x coordinate will be always zero. Why? Because look at the x-axis. Gada. X-axis with the ikkada nunchi start avutundante ikkada zero ne kada. Chudu ikkada.
Yeah.
Zero ne kada. Ikkada enta dooram ellina zero ne untadi adi. okay na, and y axis same similar in y axis, if you go however long you want, you go straight and it will be always zero. What will be zero on x axis? Here y coordinate will be zero. Y coordinate
will be zero.
Be zero. And y axis ikkada
x coordinate will be zero. Sir.
Idi anamata concept.
Yes, sir, understood.
Yes. Any doubts?
Sir, one more doubt, sir. Every point on the x-axis has zero.
Has
zero distance from x-axis, and every point on the y-axis has zero distance from y-axis, sir. I totally can't understand this one, sir.
No problem. Let us write this. Tell me. Can you please repeat it again?
Every point on the y-axis. X-axis. Has zero. Has zero distance from the x-axis. Zero distance.
From the x-axis.
And every point on the y-axis has zero distance from the y-axis.
Y-axis has zero distance from the y-axis. Ante kada. Chudu ikkada. Every point. Ikkada look at the question carefully. Statement. Look at the statement carefully. This is x-axis. This is y-axis. Every point on the x-axis. Ikkada every point on the x-axis. A point on this. Okay. Whatever the point you take on the x-axis has a zero distance from the x-axis. Ikkada nunchi isko ma. Ante on x-axis. A point on this.
Yes, sir.
Now if I say I would say zero distance, but zero distance ante ippudu every point on the x-axis has a zero distance from the x. Ippudu a point, for example, look at this, ikkada nenu three point measure chestunna y-axis. I would say this is y-axis. If I say y-axis, look at this, ikkada y-axis anko. Ikkada y-axis nunchi enta, y-axis nunchi ante ikkada nunchi enta dooram undi ante 3 units ani cheptanu nenu. Okay na? From y-axis ani unte, if I just asking you to say y-axis, I would have said 3 units. On x-axis ekkada akkada ante, look at this, ikkada on the x-axis itself ante zero ne kada.
Yes, sir, understood.
One second, guys. I can hear you. Pen is not ready. 1 second. Look at this. Can you see the pen here? I'm writing something.
Yes, sir.
Look at this. So you can write a note. Note ikkada. Note chusko. Note enti ante. You write. Etla rastam since. You write since. Every point. Since every point on the x-axis has every point on the x-axis has no distance. Every point on the x-axis has no distance, which means zero distance. from ikkada, from the x axis. So deeni batti manam em rayachu, therefore I could say that therefore y coordinate of every point lying on the x axis is always em avutadi zero avutadi idi ippudu chudu malli explain chestama nevu concentration you know since every point on the x axis has zero distance nu a point on isko ikkada ikkada x axis a point on isko అది జీరో డిస్టెన్స్ కదా ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడ పోతే సమ్ డిస్టెన్స్ అని చెప్పేవాడిని నేను అదే లైన్ మీద ఉంది కదా జీరో డిస్టెన్స్ కదా ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడ ఉన్నా కొంచెం డిస్టెన్స్ ఉంది అని చెప్పేవాడిని ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడ ఉన్నా ఐ వుడ్ హావ్ సెడ్ సమ్ డిస్టెన్స్ హియర్ ఫ్రమ్ హియర్ టు హియర్ సమ్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఐ వుడ్ హావ్ సెడ్ బట్ ఎవ్రీ పాయింట్ లైయింగ్ ఆన్ ద సేమ్ లైన్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ యు అండర్స్టాండ్ హియర్ లుక్ అట్ దిస్ హియర్ లెట్ మీ సే ఇఫ్ ఐ హావ్ సో ఫ్రమ్ హియర్ యు ఆర్ స్టాండింగ్ హియర్ ఠీక్ హై అండ్ యూ హావ్ టు రీచ్ యువర్ గోల్ హియర్ యూ హావ్ టు క్యాచ్ దట్ బాక్స్ ठीक है दैट बॉक्स इज समवेयर लाइक यू नो फोर यूनिट्स ओके एंड यू आर स्टार्टिंग ऑन वेयर एक्स एक्सिस ओके फोर यूनिट्स मतलब लुक एट दिस हियर फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर द फोर ठीक है फोर डिस्टेंस हाँ नाउ यू आर स्टैंडिंग इन अ स्टार्टिंग पोजिशन यू हैव टू मूव फॉरवर्ड टू कैच दैट बॉक्स यू आर नॉट इवन मूविंग एनीवेयर लुक एट दिस इफ यू मूव समवेयर हियर यू से अरे यार यू जस्ट मूव टू यूनिट्स हरिणी हैज मूव टू यूनिट्स आई वुड हैव सेड दैट फ्रॉम वेयर फ्रॉम द एक्स एक्सिस यू आर नॉट मूविंग फ्रॉम देयर एंड एक्स एक्सिस इटसेल्फ यू आर स्टैंडिंग देयर इटसेल्फ यू आर स्टैंडिंग मींस व्हाट जीरो डिस्टेंस नो डिस्टेंस ना हां सो एवरी पॉइंट दैट इज अ लुक एट हियर एवरी पॉइंट ऑन द एक्स एक्सिस एवरी पॉइंट ऑन द एक्स एक्सिस हैज अ नो डिस्टेंस ऑन द एक्स एक्सिस आई एम टेलिंग ऑन द एक्स एक्सिस द ऑल एक्सिस मीद पर्टिकुलर गा on the x-axis has no distance from the x-axis look at here you are standing here where you are standing on x-axis so you are a point now you are a point Harini is a point on the x-axis has a zero distance from the x-axis itself avuna kada aa x-axis nunchi ekkadiki move avatleka ande nilchuravu kada so that is the reason I could say that you are maintaining a zero distance theek hai you are in zero distance from where from the x-axis నువ్వు ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్ నుంచి ఎంత దూరంలో ఉన్నావు ఇప్పుడు జీరో డిస్టెన్స్ లోనే ఉన్నావు ఇక్కడ నుంచి కొంచెం పైకి కిందికి వెళ్ళినా ఐ వుడ్ హావ్ సెడ్ టూ యూనిట్స్ ఆర్ త్రీ యూనిట్స్ సంథింగ్ లైక్ దట్ బట్ యు ఆర్ స్టాండింగ్ ఆన్ ద సేమ్ యాక్సిస్ దెన్ ఐ కుడ్ సే దట్ యు ఆర్ హావింగ్ అ జీరో డిస్టెన్స్ ఆన్ దట్ పర్టిక్యులర్ యాక్సిస్ క్లియర్
yes sir like is the same example we have to write 0 comma 0 or any number
no.
like 3 comma 0
Look at here. Every point on the x-axis has a zero distance from the x-axis itself. So, ippudu ikkada nunchi nu, let us say that.
Like with the example, can you explain?
Yes. Look at this. Look at this here. Same. This is, look at it. This is the reason. This is the reason why we call y coordinate of every point lying on the x axis will be always zero endukante x coordinate ukka chudu y coordinate on x axis y coordinate deeni meeda a point ane isko what I said this is x axis here on x axis y coordinate will be always zero
yes sir
endukante y coordinate ikkada zero distance maintain chestundi kada ikkada zero ne kada enta dooram ane ellu zero ne untadi y coordinate will be always zero ha enduku ante this is the reason every point on the x axis has a zero distance from that axis itself ippudu chudu nenu oka example chepta plot let us say plot 2 comma plot 3 comma 0
yes sir understood now
ha 3 comma 0 plot cheyamante etla chestavu ippudu 3 anedi x coordinate ante x axis meeda 3 teeskuntam 1 2 3 3 here and 0 ante ekkada 0 ante ekkada chestavu ekkada 0 ide kada 0 ante valla
sir x axis y axis
y axis kada ante ikkada nunchi నేను ఈ పాయింట్ ఇప్పుడు ఎక్కడ మూవ్ అవ్వట్లేదు కిందికి మీదికి అంటే జీరోనే కదా
అన్నా
ఇప్పుడు ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఎక్కడ మూవ్ అవ్వట్లేదు ఇది వై యాక్సిస్ కి స్ట్రేట్ లో చూడు వై యాక్సిస్ ఇది వై యాక్సిస్ కదా ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడికి ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడ డిస్టెన్స్ ఎంత ఉంది ఎక్స్ కోఆర్డినేట్ 3 కానీ వై యాక్సిస్ డిస్టెన్స్ అయితే జీరోనే కదా ఇక్కడ నుంచి అక్కడ నుంచి ఎక్కడ మూవ్ అవ్వట్లేదు సో జీరో సో
yes sir got it
idi 3 comma 0 ani adam x coordinate is 3 y coordinate is 0 y coordinate nen em an cheppanu iku y coordinate ekkada 0 untadi x axis mida x coordinate ekkada 0 untadi y axis mida avuna kada simple yes. manu from here what you understood is on x axis y coordinate will be always 0 on y axis x coordinate will be always 0 and every yes. point on the x axis every point on the x axis has no distance from that axis itself ఇప్పుడు నువ్వు ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్ మీద నిల్చొని నాకు ఎంత నేను ఎంత డిస్టెన్స్ లో నిల్చున్నా అంటే ఏం జీరో డిస్టెన్స్ అని చెప్పాలి నువ్వు అర్థమైందా క్లియర్ ఎవ్రీ పాయింట్ ఆన్ ద ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్ హ్యాస్ నో డిస్టెన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ దేర్ ఫ్రమ్ వేర్ ఫ్రమ్ ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ యూ కెనాట్ సే దాట్ ఎవ్రీ డిస్టెన్స్ ఎవ్రీ పాయింట్ ఆన్ ద ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్ హ్యాస్ నో డిస్టెన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ద వై యాక్సిస్ అంటే మన తప్పు అవుతుంది అర్థమైందా ఇక్కడ ఇది లుక్ అట్ ది స్టేట్మెంట్ అగైన్ here if I write x axis if I write y axis this statement will be wrong now endukante every distance on the x axis has some distance from the y axis not from the yeah. x axis every distance every point on the x axis has a no distance from the x axis itself nenu ikkada y axis rasta tappu avutha statement kabatti every point on x axis has a no distance from x axis itself clear
yes sir clear
I hope I just gave you that box example there is a better example to understand
yeah yes sir
clear any doubts
sir why did you say kabaddi here
sorry
Now you were explaining, so in middle you said kabaddi.
Sorry?
Sir, you were explaining now that has no sense. So then in middle you said kabaddi.
Kabaddi is a Telugu word, ma. Okay. Kabaddi means that is the reason.
Oh, okay.
Everybody thought kabaddi means kabaddi sports.
Yes.
No problem. She doesn't know Telugu.
Yeah.
Yes. All right. Chalo. Next. Who has doubt now?
Second, we'll play quiz.
Yes, sir.
Yes, we'll play. We have time. Still like, you know, 6:10, 6:07 we'll play. Yes. What about others? Guys, many of you didn't posted the doubt here. Yes, Bargo was asking. Bargo, tell me what was your doubt? Coordinate system.
Sir, not in coordinate geometry. Oh, yeah, yes, sir. Trigonometric.
Make it
sir, more. Like, there are some identities known as sine 180 plus theta is equal to minus sine theta, sir.
Yes.
And
okay. Sine, what is that?
Yes,
sine 180
plus theta
is equal to minus
sine theta. Minus sine theta.
Your doubt is how this is?
Sir, I am not that, sir. Are there any identities like that? Any more identities?
So many. Look at this here. Cos 180 plus theta is equal to minus cos theta.
Yes, sir.
Tan 180 plus theta is equal to plus tan theta. And cosec 180 plus theta is equal to?
Sir, like that's a formula. All silver teacups.
Sir,
all in the first quadrant, yeah, all are positive. In the second quadrant, sine and
cosec. Yes, minus sine theta.
Let me talk, or else you explain me. I'll listen.
Cos 180.
Look at this here. All silver teacups. For that is not a formula, I would say. For remembering all.
Yes, sir. It's for remembering.
Silver tea कब्स ऑल मतलब ऑल ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शंस
सर ऑल आर पॉजिटिव
हियर sin एंड cos विल बी पॉजिटिव हियर tan एंड cot विल बी पॉजिटिव हियर cos एंड secant विल बी पॉजिटिव
यस सर
फॉर दैट ओनली ओके हां नाउ देयर आर plenty of examples we can give like this tan of 180 plus theta is plus tan theta cosecant of plus cosecant of 180 plus theta is equal to cosec theta and so on
sir can you tell for cosec second cot also I'll note it down so that I can easily fill the fourth quadrant table yes sir
sorry
sir can you tell for cosec second cot also sir so that I could note it down so that I could fill the fourth quadrant table
your voice is breaking Bhargav
my voice is breaking sir
no it's not breaking for me sir
tell me
sir now is it clear
yes tell me
So, can you tell the such identities for cosec second cot also, sir, so that you know I can easily fill up the 360 table. I mean, yes. The fourth quadrant table.
Look at this. So you are asking me to give cosec 180 plus theta is equal to how much? Do you want me to explain this kind of thing?
Yes, sir.
Ha! Look at this. Cosec 180 plus theta. Cosec is what? 180 plus theta in here. Tan and cot will be positive and rest will be negative okay remaining will be negative so tan and cosec will be 180 plus theta is third quadrant right in third quadrant whole are positive tan and cot so cosec 180 plus theta is nothing but positive only sorry not positive negative cosec right third quadrant tan and cot only positive rest will be cosec will be what negative now 180 whenever I have 180 plus theta 360 plus theta function will not be changing cosec will be cosec only cosec theta
okay
That's
sir
it. Now if I say cosec 90 plus theta then cosec will be changing as how
cosec 90 plus theta right sir
90 plus theta second quadrant so second quadrant whole are positive sin and cosec will be positive so positive only my answer
yes, sir.
So 90 plus theta means cosec will be changing as how
cosec 90 plus theta will be plus only
but I'm saying that see here sin will be changing as cos tan will be changing as
what's the use of it
cot
cot
secant will be changing as
cosec
cosecant then what do you say here secant theta
then what is the use of this
so we'll be finding a quadrant system which function is you know which function is lying in which quadrant it comes in trigonometry in term to we'll learn this
sir actually I have already learned this in IIT
yes so with this what do you understand is for suppose if I have sin 180 degrees sin is a trigonometry function so for finding sin for finding the values of you know this kind of thing sin 180 degrees is how much if 180 degrees of for the sin function what is the value of that so this kind of things you will be getting to know here okay so yes any doubts about
sir it took me time sir by for filling all the tables it actually took me time because I was using the formulas sin a plus b is equal to sin a cos b plus cos a sin b and cos a b is equal to cos a cos b minus sin a sin b
yes Yes, any doubts here? Any doubts, Bhargav, apart from this?
No, sir, no doubts.
So, sir, basically, can I explain once again what should we do with them?
Like trigonometry, right?
Yes, Piyush, what do you want me to explain? Tell me.
So, like, what is the use of these all things?
Like, using trigonometry, we can find the altitudes of some mountains.
Look at this, sir. Piyush will be talking about this chapter in a trick prompt to syllabus. After this, you know, we'll be straight away going for that. Or else if you want me to, like, you know, if you want me to if you want me to explain the quadrant system, it takes time. So basically we'll be finding, you know, for finding positive, negative values, for finding positive, negative values. And basically look at this here. If I just tell you what exactly the use of this. By using that quadrant system, trigonometric equations can be solved, basically. And this trigonometry, what is that? What is the use? Trigonometric equations can be solved. Like, you know, you have quadratic equations, right? So you have, let us say, so x square plus x plus 2 is equal to 0, right? If I have sine square x plus sine x plus 2 is equal to 0, for solving this kind of theta, for solving this kind of equations, we'll be using that. That is the one thing, right? And now let us say measuring the altitude, as I, you know, Bhargav said, altitude is nothing but height. Okay,
yes,
measuring, you know,
yes,
height,
sir.
Altitude of the particular, you know, celestial and other landscape objects. So that kind of, you know, practical, you know, use actually. And basically, why do we use trigonometry functions? Obtaining unknown angles. For if we do not know angles, right? We do not know. For finding unknown angles. For finding unknown angles. And distance. For finding distance. Distance from known. From distance from known or measured angles in a geometric figures. Okay? For finding unknown angles and finding distance from known or measured angles of geometrical figures. This is what, you know, this is why we use. This is why we use trigonometric functions. So you just don't worry. We'll, you know, explain in a trigonometric chapter. Okay? All right?
Yes, sir.
Sir, I mean, trigonometry is there in my class?
Yes, tell me.
So you mean trigonometry is there in ninth class?
Trigonometry, yes. When I just learned, we studied the basics of trigonometry. But no, we will explain basics of trigonometry as per, you know, as a part of IIT syllabus. Not an issue. Okay, shall we make a move for a quiz now? We don't have time.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Chalo, which part do you want me to conduct? Which chapter? Make it fast. We don't have time immediately.
The triangles.
Triangles. One second. I think I can find only one thing here. Let's see. Join the quiz immediately. Make it fast.
Sir, again, name boss 2 has entered.
It was in previous, it was bus 1 and then our bus 2.
Please, 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 wait, wait. Please, you start, start joining the group.
Sir, I'm not able to join, sir. I don't know what is happening. It's saying some error. Just come.
Everyone should join. Please rejoin, rejoin. Make it fast, make it. We don't have time. Come on.
Sir, some error is coming, sir.
Join with another device. Or else you can attempt it later, tell me the marks. Copy this link, try at home, tell me the marks. Okay, Bhargav? Those who are not able to join, guys, please copy this link.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, children, let's get started now. I'm just starting the quiz. Make it fast, only 4 minutes we have. 10 questions, 3 minutes. Make it fast, last 30 seconds.
So done, sir.
Make it fast, Taruni, make it fast, Devasri. Make it fast, then time up. Let me stop here. Harini, make it fast. Taruni, make it fast.
Yes, sir. 1 minute. I rejoined as I disconnected. Sir.
No problem. Make it fast. Time up, guys, time up. Yes, I'm going to stop this. Let me stop. Harini first, Pranav second, Ananya third.
Sir, what happened to boss, sir?
I removed him. Tarani, you got 100%, very good. Yes, Piyush also got 100%. Many of you got 100%. So Aditya 100%, Taruni 100%. Tayaba 80%, Suja 80%, Harini 60%. Two times you adopted. Okay, okay. Devasti 20%. No problem.
Sir,
yes. So many of you.
Sir, why you
pause at the quiz? Hey, man. Let us not discuss unnecessary topic. Please. Look at this here. Sujay 80%. Harini, okay. Devasri, you just have to, you know, attempt so fast, ma. So everyone got very good. And don't know who is boss. I just removed him. He has finished before than all of you. So I just removed him. Not an issue. Yeah. So we'll write, keep writing this kind of question, like, you know, keep quizzes in future as well. Thank you. And please, everyone should attempt the quiz.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.
Bye.
Bye, sir.